Look at this. Oh, it feels so good.
What does it look like? Oh, it's really hard.
That's what $3 of dog ice cream looks like.
Ours was much longer. You know anywhere Anubis? I should fight for it.
Anubis, yes she does. Watch this. Go ahead.
You have to give it to her one at a time.
Mocha. Alright, sit. Sit. Leave it.
I think they like it.
I think they do.
We are headed north of the Chesapeake from Kippity Peak State Park. We're heading to Cape Charles. We have a couple of boat repairs that we need to have done. We have a clutch that broke, so we're going to go ahead and replace all of our clutches with a different brand. And we also have a gauge that broke that we're going to get fixed there. So we've got some repairs to do, so we're going to be there for about a week. What are you looking forward to doing in Cape Charles?
Well, we've been there before, and they have a great restaurant, so if all works out and things are open, we will go check out the restaurants. There's also a number of soul train cars. There's a number of different shops that are just kind of knick-knack shops that are fun to look at.
There's a brewery and there's an ice cream shop. One thing I'm looking forward to doing is making some screens. We're gonna buy some netting as well as some frames to make them because we picked up an awful case of flies while we were down in Kippity Peak State Park. So we want to keep them out from now on.
I found some standard do-it-yourself kits so you can make your own multis in different sizes, and I bought them so that the diameters are wide enough to fit our existing ports, so I think they're going to work.
So we only have about 9 nautical miles to do, so this sail's going pretty fast.
Yes, it will, and the harbor is fairly easy to get right into.
Nuala sees a fly. Nuala gets flies. Hi guys, I'm with the Labmariners and we're right across from our boat at Cape Charles Yacht Center where we're having a little bit of work done on it. Stay Anubis.
What does perfect even mean? Is there even such a thing? Ooh, ooh. Can we switch up all the rules and imagine a utopia? Darling, I'm just so fed up with these expectations.
Cape Charles Public Beach. You are not allowed from 9 to 9 p.m. So we get a little bit of time before you gotta, guys gotta get off the beach this morning.
Yeah.
Now they're able to get, now they're getting some chunks.
They're so pretty. Are they all siblings?
No, they're all different ages. They came from different states, no less. From West Virginia, she's from South Carolina, and she is from Illinois.
Oh, wow. So what are their names?
Anubis, Mocha, and Nuala.
Aw. You said Anubis?
Yes, Anubis.
Oh, I like that. I like that.
No, you can't have the decaf coffee. It's decaf, but you still can't have it.
They're not getting very much.
Yes, they are. They're enjoying
it's
the heck out of it.
It's taking a while. Thank you for the kisses.
It's about a third of the way gone, so it's we're getting our money's worth out of it.
They stay in that deep freezer the whole time.
Exactly.
It's
we're getting our money's worth. They're not gobbling it down.
Yeah. Get your iframe.
Leave it.
Get your iframe.
Sticking her nose in it almost.
Yeah. Nuba, sit.
Sit. Aw, back face.
They're so good waiting their turn.
No.
Wonder where that came from. I wonder where they got to be so good.
There's three obedience training classes I did with each of them.
Yeah, something like that.
It was all agility training.
Maybe they know that dad's an authoritarian when it comes to a dog. Okay, leave it. Leave it. Right, you got it. No. Mocha. Leave it. Okay, Mocha, no more. Good girl. Good girl.
They have a double golf cart here.
Yeah, they have like triples too.
Do they? That would be very hard. No. Up. She's having none of it. She thinks you're crazy. You're crazy, Dad.
I could pick you up.
I know you could pick her up, but then you'd have to pick all of the other two dogs up, too.
100 years ago, when they came here, the Chesapeake, all it was with just one giant shellfish. Just gather them up.
The oysters were so thick. Oh, yeah. Right next to the
oysters.
See how he uses his back legs as fins? There's actually another one right to the left of him.
Behind him?
No, there's to the left of the blue crab, there's another one that's quiet. It's sitting there with its legs curled under. He's grabbing and feeding food into his mouth.
On the Chesapeake, or when you're anchoring close to shore in hot and humid areas, no-see-em, mosquitoes and flies can be an issue. We found that we need to have mesh inserts for some of our ports. Most of our vertical ports do not have screens. All of our horizontal ports pointing up have screens, and that's wonderful most of the time, but when it's raining, it would be nice to have a little bit of airflow to keep the interior of our vessel cooler. I found a kit made by Primeline. You get these 48-inch tracks, you get these corner pieces, you get this rubber line that is used to hold in the screen. With that basic kit, you're able to make any size screen for your ports. Right now we have 5 different locations where we wanted to have screens, which we built. One of the unique facets with this system is instead of having to cut at a 45-degree angle and piece them together, they actually have these connections that do the 90-degree connections for you, so you end up just cutting horizontal to the strip itself. Here's an example of 2 pieces that were left over from the project that I did. So what you end up doing is putting them together like this and inserting both corners, press it all the way up. They fit really nicely and snugly. As a result, there's very little racking. It also closes off, so it makes it look fairly clean. And then once you have all 4 corners put together like that, you cut out a piece of the mesh that overlaps the outside of the frame itself. And then you use this rubberized gasket to actually press. Let's see, it'd be like looking like this. And you actually put this gasket in here, starting at the corner, and you press in. And then you use this little tool.
Does it come with the tool?
Depending on the kit, there are a lot of different kits, but you can buy this separate or together. It actually has a little track on here, a little groove, and you just basically run this down and put the mesh in. You end up cutting away all the extra mesh with the straight knife, and it comes all out and ends up looking quite professional. And it's very sturdy. The only thing that is really tricky is actually laying the screen in where the tightness here is either, it's just got to be just right. You don't want it too loose. If you tighten across the mesh, this drum part here, too tight, it'll either rip very quickly or it'll start to rack. This doesn't rack at all. Once you make a mistake or two and learn kind of the right stretch, these are really easy to make and they're easy to store when we don't use them. And they end up even fitting the color and texture of our vessel.